Here's a story straight out of science fiction, replacing human pregnancies with artificial wombs. I know the idea sounds dystopian, but it may be a fast-approaching reality.
Be warned, things are about to get a little freaky. Every once in a while, science crosses the thin line between amazing and downright freaky. And this is definitely one of those times. Introducing EctoLife, a facility reportedly able to incubate up to 30,000 lab-grown babies per year. Yeah, you heard that right, lab-grown babies. Hashem El-Galili is credited with creating this concept. According to his website, he is a producer, filmmaker, science communicator, and molecular biologist by profession who lives and works in Berlin. Through the use of synthetic wombs, it allows parents to create customized babies. This crazy concept will enable people to edit their babies. You can also select your baby's IQ level, height, eye color, skin tone, hair color, and physical attributes through an elite package. So, what exactly is this concept? What is the artificial womb facility? What are its features and why is EctoLife needed? Let's take a look. It may seem like science fiction to see a human fetus growing outside of a human uterus, but artificial wombs are soon becoming a reality. An artificial womb could be used to nurture an undeveloped fetus until it is strong enough to thrive outside the womb on its own. For instance, 8 lambs that were born preterm in 2017 were successfully developed by researchers at the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia by placing them in artificial wombs for 4 weeks. The biobag, also referred to as an artificial womb, is a sizable plastic bag that encloses the fetus and is filled with an electrolyte solution that is comparable to amniotic fluid. A lamb that was born prematurely can continue to grow within the biobag, where it can open its eyes, expand its brain and lungs, move about, and produce wool. It's not so crazy that we can grow lambs in artificial wombs, but what about real human babies? That's what EctoLife is all about. According to Al-Galili, the EctoLife concept is based on over 50 years of groundbreaking scientific research. According to the UK's Metro newspaper, the facility, which would be powered by renewable energy, would have 75 labs with up to 400 development pods or artificial wombs in each. The environment within these pods is intended to be similar to that found in a mother's womb. According to Metro, parents can monitor their child's growth and development through a screen on the pods that shows real-time data. This data can also be monitored by the parents on their phones through an app. Al-Galili was quoted by mirror.co.uk as saying, "The artificial intelligence-based system also monitors the physical features of your baby and reports any potential genetic abnormalities." You can deliver your baby stress-free with the help of EctoLife, which offers a painless, safe alternative. Pushing a button is all that is required to complete the simple, convenient delivery process. You will be able to effortlessly remove your child from the growing pod after the artificial womb has released its amniotic fluid. Every growing pod has sensors that keep an eye on vital signs, including heartbeat, oxygen saturation, temperature, respiration, and blood pressure. An AI system also keeps an eye on physical characteristics and looks for any potential genetic anomalies. Babies are also steadily and sustainably maintained by 2 central bioreactors to ensure and encourage good growth. In the first bioreactor, a synthetic umbilical cord is used to pump nutrients, essential hormones, antibodies, growth factors, oxygen, and a liquid solution resembling amniotic fluid. Additionally, each baby receives personalized nutrients customized to their needs owing to an AI-run system. The waste materials that the infant releases through the artificial umbilical cord are absorbed and recycled in the second bioreactor. EctoLife's operations are all centered on technology. On the one hand, a screen attached to the growth pod shows every vital sign and transmits real-time data to the parent's phone so they can monitor their child's health from afar. Parents can see a high-resolution live view of each developmental stage through the app, which also includes a growing time-lapse that can be shared with loved ones. Additionally, Each artificial womb is equipped with speakers that play music or transmit the voices of the parents to the unborn child. On the other hand, a parent's VR headset can also be connected to a 360-degree camera within the developmental pod, enabling them to see and hear everything the baby sees and hears. And that's not all. Parents will also be able to share their experience of feeling their baby kick in the womb with their friends and family members through a wireless haptic suit connected to the baby's development pod. Last but not least, solar and wind energy specifically power the entire operating system. As a result, there won't be any unanticipated problems during the baby's entire growth and development. The sci-fi experience can also be offered outside of a lab setting. In this surreal yet future-proof scenario, parents who prefer a more personal option can build their own growing pods at home, backed by miniature bioreactors with long-lasting batteries. This will add an added layer of comfort and protection. You can also choose the Elite Package, which enables genetic engineering of the embryo prior to implantation into a synthetic womb. You can choose your genetic predispositions for traits like IQ, height, strength, and even hair and eye color. EctoLife, according to Hashem, is the first artificial womb facility in the world and is totally powered by renewable energy. According to the World Health Organization, WHO, pregnancy-related problems account for about 300,000 fatalities each year. EctoLife will contribute to a decrease in both C-sections and human suffering. Premature births and C-sections could also be history thanks to the EctoLife concept. Hashem continued by saying that EctoLife will provide solutions for women who need to have their uterus removed as a result of difficulties. It would benefit populous declining nations like South Korea, Bulgaria, Japan, and so on. According to Al-Ghalili, if ethical constraints are lifted, artificial womb facilities could be a reality in around 10 years. According to him, every single element specified in the concept is wholly founded on science and has already been accomplished by engineers and scientists. The only thing left to do is construct a prototype by fusing every feature into a single device. According to him, once ethical restraints are lifted, individuals will be willing and open to utilizing the technology in the near future. Nevertheless, despite the fact that the video presents an ambitious and utopian vision, viewers cannot help but notice the ominous undertones that appear in every frame, leading them to consider the ramifications of such a concept. This user on Twitter, for example, said, "They are making artificial babies in artificial wombs, like a farm. Remember, they have cloning facilities. This is only the tip of the iceberg. They are trying to be God. I wonder what's next." Right before we jump into the next part, if you make it this far, make sure to like and subscribe for more content like this. So, what do scientists really think about this concept? According to Professor Joyce Harper, director of the UCL Institute for Women's Health's Reproductive Science and Society Group, this is a very real possibility. What the future of reproduction might eventually be is covered in great detail in one chapter of her book, Your Fertile Years. She tells HuffPost UK, "I have no doubt that at some point most people will be produced by IVF, and that this EctoLife would be a possibility. In science, I think you should never say never. If you think of the last 50 years and what we've achieved, that you would have never thought of. I'm quite old, so I remember watching Star Trek when they were doing video calls. And you know, I never thought I'd be video calling my kids on FaceTime." She points out that an IVF lab can effectively complete the first 4 weeks of pregnancy. Women are typically 4 weeks pregnant when an embryo is transferred. And today, preterm babies can begin receiving care in an incubator within a neonatal unit as early as 21 weeks. Andrew Sheenan, a professor of obstetrics at King's College London, told HuffPost that it is very possible from a theoretical standpoint and that it's just a matter of providing the right environment with fuel and oxygen. and he believes the technologies are in place to do so. There are a lot of examples where babies come out extremely early and are very well looked after in incubators, which is a very naive form of what you're talking about, and they're being fed by tubes down to their stomach. When we put people on things like heart bypasses or other organ bypasses, we are theoretically giving them what they need from a machine. The EctoLife concept video mentions providing a elite package in which babies' genomes will be modified to change their intelligence level, height, physical strength, and skin tone. It's interesting that Professor Harper believes that this won't have any ethical impact on future generations. She once participated in a discussion at the Oxford Union over whether genome editing would undermine the nature of humanity. What do you think about this concept? Let us know down in the comments section below.